In Babel, displaying data is pretty easy. You drag and drop a repeating group on your page, you connect it to your own app data, and there you go. But if you have a lot of data to display, you might end up having performance issues with your app. In fact, if you don't set up your repeating groups properly, Babel will try to load all your items at once, which will lead to longer page time load and an increase in workload unit consumption. Which is why in this video, you are going to learn how to limit the number of items displayed by default in a repeating group, and you will also learn how to create a show more button that will increase the number of items displayed in your repeating group. Alright, there we go. So, to do this tutorial, I'm going to use a block section component that I'm going to take from NoCodable Components library. If you want to try it, you can find the link in the description. But it will work with pretty much any repeating group. So there we go, I paste it. So I'm gonna simply adapt it to my own app data. So I've created a bunch of dummy blog posts. So as you can see, I've got author first name, job title, last name, and so on. So let me just adapt this to my data. If you already have a repeating group set up, you can go a little bit further in the video. So I'm gonna change it to blog post. I'm gonna do a search for blog post. And there we go. And now I simply have to change a few data here. In all my group, I'm gonna display parents group blog post thumbnail. Alright, it's all set up. So let's do a preview, see how it looks like. And then we can move on and really do the thing. So as we can see, I have a bunch of blog posts, which in itself is not a bad idea. But for example, if I'm on a homepage and let's say that I have two or three times as much blog posts, well, I don't want to load all the blog posts on my homepage because first it takes a lot of space, and also because I'm going to have a lot of workload unit and of resources to download that is not useful on my page. So I'm going to have to constraint that search to only return a number of items. So to do that, the first thing to do is to create a custom state that will hold the number of items we want to display. So let's create it. I'm going to put it on my page. I'm going to call it number items to show, for example, and it will be a type number. Number. There we go. So now I have to give it a default value. In my case, I only have 15 blog posts, but you can have 1,000 records that you want to display. So in my case, I'm going to say that I'm going to show only 5 blog posts by default. So when my page will load, only 5 blog posts will be displayed. So now that we have this custom state, we need to actually use it to constrain our search in our repeating group. So let's get back to our repeating group in our property panel, and in our search for blog post, we are going to say, okay, I want to search for blog post or whatever data type you want to use, and I'm going to get the items until number. So I'm going to get the items until the nth number, and I'm going to take my repeating group, which is on my page, so rz show more, and the number of items to show. So basically, now I'm saying, okay, you do a search for blog post and you only take the X number of items. So basically it will by default give me only the 5 first blog posts of my search. And this is a really important thing because if you are an e-commerce platform or a marketplace, you might end up having thousands of items that you want to show, or at least that you have in your database, but you don't want to always show 1,000 items on each page load, because you will end up having a lot of workload unit consumption and very important page load time. So with this, you can simply constrain it to by default show only the 20 first items, or maybe 40 or 60 or as much as you need, but you won't have to load each time the 1,000 items. So let's make a quick preview to see if what we did actually worked. And there we go, we can see that we have only 5 blog posts now. Now that we have constrained our search, we need to actually add a button that will enable us to load more blog posts in this case. So I'm going to add a button just under my repeating group. Don't add it into your repeating group, just under it. I'm going to make it here, and I'm going to make last, I'm going to center it, and then we can style it a little. So I'm going to take the blue I use, let's make some roundness, and then I'm going to call it show more. Alright, so now we have this button, and when we click it, we want to actually increase the number of results that we want to show. So if you understand me, it means that we are going to increase the value that we stored previously in our custom state. So let's do that, add a workflow, and we are going to use a set state of an element action. Where is my state? I put it on my page. You can retrieve it wherever you attached it. So number of items to show, and I'm going to reference this custom state to start from its value and add a certain number. So I'm going to retake rgShowMore, which is my page, number of items to show, and now I'm going to add a certain number. You can choose whatever number you like, 20, 40, 60, doesn't matter, it depends on your use case. In my case, once again, I only have 15 blog posts, so I'm going to add, I'm going to add 5 blog posts each time I click on the Show More button. And there we go. So now, if we make a preview, we see that I have my button, it loaded. So I have, once again, 5 items, 5 blog posts, and if I click, I have a lot more. And there we go. And now, I have all my items because I have 15 blog posts, and I have 15 blog posts in my database. So now we need to actually do one more thing, which is to hide this button when we don't have any more data to show. And how do we do that? Simply, we are going to add a conditional on our button that will say that when our custom state, which is the number of items we want to display, is higher than or equal to the actual number of items we have in our database, then we want to hide the button because it means that we don't have any more items to actually show to the user. So let's do that. On our button, you add a conditional, and we are going to get our custom state, number of items to show, is superior or equal to, and you are going to take the same search that you do in a repeating group. We cannot actually take the number of items in a repeating group because it is already constrained in numbers to this. So we are going to superior or equal to do a search for, in my case, blog post. So you need to really take the exact same search that you have in your repeating group, but we will this time take the count, which is the number of items that our search returns. And then what we can do is simply uncheck this element is visible, and you can also check collapse when hidden so that it doesn't take any space on your page. So let's do this. Let's hit preview and see what it does. So I have my 5 blog posts, now I'm my 10, and then when I click, you can see that my button is gone because I don't have any more blog posts to show. And there you go. Now you know how to create the show more button in a repeating group, and also the most important thing, which is to actually limit the number of items in your repeating group. It's a big best practice that you need to implement on every app you work on because it will really help a lot to load pages faster, but also to keep your workload unit consumption as low as possible. I hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to subscribe and to like it. And if you want to try out no-codable components, you will find the link to it in the description. Cheers, bye-bye.